saw the part of you that only when you're older you'll see too. You'll see too. I held the better cards, but every stroke of luck has gotta bleed through. It's gotta bleed through. You held the balance of the time that only blindly I could read you. But I could read you.
Good morning, how are you? Good, we only just missed us. They got it. Well, you never know. You never know. Hi, my name's Dave. I've had a big issue in Canterbury. This is my place of residence at the moment. I choose to be here. It's not through circumstance. It's idyllic. You couldn't wish for a better place, really. It's can be cruel, but then again, the payback's a second to none, really. You could be anywhere in the world. Rule number one: everything's got to be rat-proof. Everything that's edible's got to be put away, apart from the bird feeder. But then they even managed to get that. Basically, all that is there's a membrane, and then underlay carpet, and carpet goes up the sides, and that's constructed of hazel, and then a canvas sheet, a tarpaulin sheet, and then a second tarpaulin sheet, which gives you there's a gap in between them, and which gives you that difference in temperature between the outside and the inside, and even if it's only a couple of 3 degrees that it makes a difference. Going into town, you see there was two vendors, and I got talking to the vendors, and I got the word with the fella who was distributing. It was Nigel, I don't know his second there, and he offered me an opportunity to do it, which I took, and then that was near enough 18 months ago. And that's given me the opportunity to feed myself and the dog, and allows me to survive here. Make sure the sofa's clean, you know. Come on in, off we go. Go on in, off you go. Go on, off. This is the cricketer's pub in Canterbury, St. Peter Street, at the end of the High Street. And they helped me, you know, they're good enough to let me leave my vending gear here. Saves me having to lug it up and down every day, as you can imagine with what you've seen so far. It's not exactly round the corner. And this is my payback, you know. It's cost nothing in my time, split a few logs, and they're good enough to keep, especially in this weather, warm drinks and soup and all sorts of goodies coming out my way, and I'm just on the corner over there. That's in a bit, Gary. Cheers, mate. I've never been homeless because I mean, my way of getting away from stuff was just sort of like pack a bag and go and disappear in the Lake District or up in Scotland or on Brecon Beacons or Dartmoor, or, you know, I've not been homeless, no. I just, you know, that was my way of, if it was getting on top of me, whereas dealing with issues or whatever, like normal people, my way of dealing with them was not flight, but sort of like, I can't handle this. I'm going to end up sort of like, I've got no patience, if you like, with civilians in a way. I joined the Marines virtually straight from school. It was exhilarating, with the prize at the end of it, a green berry. and once you've got it, the world's your oyster. You know, the finest fighting force in the world, really.
Oh.
No,
you're
right.
Do you want a coffee? Black coffee or milk coffee?
Can I have a coffee with white coffee, one sugar, please, love?
Yep, okay.
Thank you very much, love. There's a lot of ex-servicemen, you know, that are wandering the shores, you know. Never really come to terms with civilian street. A friend of mine, he's in Broadmoor now, and he's never hurt anybody in his life. He was just... They just treated him as a loose cannon, you know.
£2.50,
sir. Yeah, it's gone up since Christmas, sir.
I meant to get some before. Yeah. Special present, so you can keep the change.
Thank you very much, sir. Very kind of you, sir. Thank you.
Obviously, you get your people who are concerned about you, always asking, you know, how are you? And there's one or two, but they ask where you live, and you try and explain that you're wild camping, you know, and they don't comprehend what that involves, you know. They see people selling the issue as either addicts or not just homeless, or homeless for a reason, you know. And you seem to get tarred with the same brush, but not two people that are alike, really. You know, the issue has given me an opportunity to survive like this, and I can't knock it, you know. Long may it continue. It's doing a good job. It gives people independence that the system doesn't.
Take care. I will. Thank you very much for worrying about me. You take care and keep warm, won't you?
It's surprising what you need to survive. You know, you just need food. And that's the only cost, really. Food and clothing, obviously. You've got to wear the proper gear here. If I can make, you know, 70, 80 quid a week, I'm a millionaire, you know?
It's like you told me, go forward slowly.